that's saying, I know what they're going through, because I've been through it, amen.
Amen.
And believe me, it ain't cool, amen.
Amen.
Ain't cool. So now, what I'm saying here, when I say Oprah is an antichrist, that is to say she are not teaching just like the Bible says.
Right.
She's not on course with the Bible.
Amen. Amen.
And see now, one thing about now, let us get this about an antichrist. As I say it, an antichrist is someone that opposes the teaching of Jesus.
Amen.
They opposes the teaching of Jesus' apostles.
Amen.
In other words, somebody like St. Paul, amen.
Amen.
They oppose it, amen.
Amen.
They will say that it's all right for a woman to preach in the church, to teach, amen.
Amen.
They oppose the teaching of St. Paul.
Amen.
Amen.
But he says a shame. Amen.
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 He says a shame for them to do it.
Amen.
But a lot of people, if they get up and preach, make a speech, they'll get a big hand clap. Amen.
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 But he says a shame. Amen.
Amen.
But now notice here, speaking about Antichrist, St. John was saying that many antichrists have came already.
Amen.
Now, when I say Oprah is an antichrist, I'm not saying she's the only one.
Amen.
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 I didn't say that. No.
Amen.
I didn't say that.
Amen.
What I did say, she is one. Amen.
Amen.
But now, according to John, he said there are many. Amen.
Yeah.
There are many.
Yeah.
And some of y'all may have heard about this preacher called the Reverend Billy Graham. Uh-huh. Amen. Yes, he was ordained by Baptist peoples, from my understanding. But now I'm telling you, he just maybe may have been one himself. I see a lot of people, you know, they say, oh, he's gone on, gone on. But now, like what I said to you on last Sunday, his net worth was something like $25 million.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm telling you, according to the way the Bible reads, no man or no woman would want to come before the judgment seat of Christ, amen.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
To give an account of his deeds that's been done in his body, according to St. Paul, what he says there in Corinthians 2nd verse 5 and 10.
Mm-hmm.
It says we all must appear before the judgment seat of Christ and to give an account of the deeds that have been done in our body, whether they are good or whether they are bad.
Amen.
So now what I'm saying is, even about the preacher, Reverend Billy Graham, I wouldn't want to have to come before the judgment seat of Christ and I'm worth $25
million.
Right. Amen. Amen. I wouldn't want to do that. I'd rather come, I'm broke, amen. I'm much like the poor man, Lazarus. I'd much rather come before the seat of Christ. I'd much rather come like somebody's on welfare, amen.
Amen.
On aid, amen.
Amen.
I'd much rather come, amen.
Right.
Yeah.
Because, you know, he said that a camel can go through the eye of a needle.
Yeah.
More easy than a rich man can enter into the kingdom of heaven.
Amen.
Amen. And amen. When we talk about what the preacher had, that's almost do make him look like a poor man when you think about what Oprah had.
Amen.
Amen.
Now some says she walked 2.7 billion. And then some says as much as 3.1 billion.
Mm-hmm.
It says her salary for a year is something like $275 million. Amen. Now this is the main reason that Sister Oprah can persuade people to believe what she is talking about. Amen.
Amen.
And see what I'm talking about, what you're talking about. One bad thing is about same-sex marriage. See now, you know, I watch this all on YouTube. Those that have a computer, you can pull up on YouTube. Amen. And you can find out much about her. Amen.
Amen.
So the way she speak about same-sex marriage is like it's a wonderful thing. Like our former governor, Quinn. He said when he signed the bill, he said it's a wonderful day. That's what he said. It's a wonderful day. Amen. But he's an antichrist himself. He's an antichrist. That is said, he opposes the teaching of Christ.
Amen.
He opposes the teaching of Jesus' apostles.
Amen.
He become an opponent. Amen.
Yeah,
like a boxer. I used to box also, Reverend, a long time ago. And so, the announcer would say to this guy, and then he'd say, and his opponent is Kenneth Harvey. Amen.
Amen.
And then I'm ready to head a bail. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
So now what I'm saying is that when you speak concrete to what this Bible is saying, then you become an opponent.
Amen.
You one that opposes the teaching of Jesus.
All right.
You become an antichrist. Amen.
Yeah.